Hello anatomy friends, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this last video for the skeletal system basics session, I want to talk the very basics of the axial and appendicular skeletons before we get into the specifics of each bone of the skeleton. So, in this video, the goal is to understand what types of bones make up the axial and appendicular skeletons and where they are located. So I think we can easily handle this, so let's get started. We will start with the axial skeleton because this portion of the skeleton will have less bones than the axial or than the appendicular, excuse me, with a mere 80 bones. Which seems like a lot, but it's not quite as much as what we have with the appendicular. The axial skeleton will consist of bones that lie around the longitudinal axis of the human body. And the longitudinal axis is this imaginary line that runs vertically through the middle of the body. So, in general terms, the bones of the skull, as well as the thoracic cage, and all of the vertebrae, or the vertebral column, will be part of the axial skeleton. The appendicular skeleton is going to be composed of 126 bones, give or take some sesamoid bones. But many of these bones are quite small, and a great majority of these can be found in the hands and the feet. So that's really where that number count goes up. And these bones are found in your appendages, or your upper and your lower limbs. And these will also include bones of the pectoral girdle, as well as the pelvic girdle, which will connect these appendicular skeletal bones to the axial skeleton. All right, I told you we could handle these concepts. Not too bad, right? But before we finish off this session, let's work through a question together. So the question is, the ribs are a part of which part of the skeleton? Is it the appendicular skeleton or the axial skeleton? So first off, you have to think about where the ribs are. And I know we haven't discussed the individual bones yet, but I specifically picked out a set of bones that I know you have a general idea of the location. Think of your rib cage, which is part of your thoracic cage. And the bones of the thoracic cage are near that longitudinal axis. Therefore, the ribs are going to be part of the axial skeletons. Or skeleton. Ribs are not part of your upper or lower limbs, so they would not be part of the appendicular skeleton. All right, so thank you for your time here, and as always, please feel free to reach out with any questions. Have a great rest of your day.